Okay, so imagine a bottleneck so critical that its disruption could halt entire industries and cost millions of jobs. That's the situation with the Soo Locks, where outdated infrastructure is a ticking time bomb for economic chaos. The Soo Locks, located in Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan, are operated by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. But what are locks exactly? Think of locks like water elevators for ships. They move vessels between bodies of water at different elevations, letting them navigate changes in water levels smoothly. At the Soo Locks, these water elevators help ships bypass a 21-foot waterfall drop in the St. Marys River, making safe passages possible between Lake Superior and the lower Great Lakes. These locks are a big deal for the U.S. economy, moving 75 million tons of cargo and around 7,000 passengers every year. They're especially important for the steel industry, as a large chunk of U.S. iron ore passes through this narrow corridor. Without the Soo Locks functioning properly, the ripple effects could be massive, disrupting supply chains and putting countless jobs at risk. Currently, the Soo Locks feature two main locks, the MacArthur Lock and the Poe Lock. These engineering marvels are more than just passageways. They're the backbone of the Great Lakes shipping system and a critical piece of the U.S. economy. The Poe Lock in particular handles the largest vessels transporting iron ore and other essential commodities, making it indispensable for industries across the nation, especially steel manufacturing, which heavily relies on the iron ore shipped through these waters. Any disruption of the Soo Locks could send shockwaves through the economy, impacting supply chains and industries far beyond the Great Lakes region. That makes keeping the locks running smoothly not just an economic priority, but also a matter of national security. A 2015 study by the Department of Homeland Security highlighted what could happen if Poe Lock were to close for 6 months. A staggering, get this, $1.1 trillion economic loss and the potential for 11 million job losses across the country. That alone underscores just how important these locks are, not only to transportation, but also a key part of the country's security infrastructure. Originally conceived in the mid-19th century, the Soo Locks were able to connect the vast resources of Lake Superior to the rest of the Great Lakes. Now they're undergoing a major upgrade. The project aims to replace two smaller locks with one that matches the size of the Poe Lock, 1,200 feet long, 110 feet wide, and 32 feet deep. Currently the only lock capable of handling modern Laker shipping vessels on the St. Marys River between Michigan and Ontario, Canada. The Soo Locks have been a cornerstone of American trade since the late 18th century. The first efforts to construct these locks began with the Northwest Fur Company in 1798, but this initial attempt was thwarted during the War of 1812 when American forces destroyed the lock to disrupt British trade. The first U.S. lock, known as the State Lock, was built in 1855 and operated by the state of Michigan. This project, alongside the Erie Canal, marked a significant step in U.S. engineering and commerce, facilitating the transportation of vital resources for industrial growth. As demand for shipping increased, the Soo Locks complex expanded, adding several new locks over time. The Whitesell Lock, completed in 1881, accommodated larger vessels but was eventually replaced by the MacArthur Lock in 1943, built during World War II to ensure a steady flow of materials for wartime logistics. The Poe Lock, introduced in 1896, got upgraded in 1968 to handle even larger ships, while the Davis and Sabin Locks, completed in the early 20th century, were decommissioned in 2010 as shipping needs and technology evolved. The scope of the newly awarded contract includes constructing 21 chamber monoliths for both the north and south walls of the new lock. Each monolith is about 44 feet wide and 70 feet tall, built by pouring concrete in 5-foot-high lifts. The work's being led by Kokosing Alberici Trailer, a joint venture involving Kokosing Industrial, Alberici Constructors, and Trailer Brothers under a $1.1 billion base contract awarded in 2022 for the third, final, and largest phase of the lock project. The contract allows early work on the project while funding continues to roll in. So far, three other contract options worth a combined $281.3 million have been awarded. Since late 2022, the contractor has been busy placing cells for upstream and downstream cofferdams, starting construction on a bridge to a mid-river hydropower plant, stabilizing existing structures, and preparing for further dewatering and excavation. Crews have been busy dewatering the site, handling electrical work, building a bridge to a new power plant, demolishing the old Sabin lock, filling up the old Davis lock chamber, and excavating bedrock to start pouring concrete for the new lock's walls this fall. While the MacArthur Lock is still operational for smaller vessels, the Poe Lock is the only one that can handle the massive 1,000-foot-long ships carrying millions of tons of iron ore from mines in Minnesota and northern Michigan to steel mills along the Great Lakes. The Pollock is critical, but it's also operating beyond its intended lifespan. It's 55 years old with a dedicated lifespan of 50 years, making it the weak link in the supply chain of iron ore. According to Molly Mahoney, the New Lock project manager, even a brief unscheduled outage of the Pollock could disrupt 75% of the nation's high-strength steel production, causing a shutdown in automobile, appliance, and heavy equipment manufacturing nationwide. A six-month outage could lead to 11 million lost jobs and a staggering $1.1 trillion economic impact. Maintenance work on the Pollock, including replacing some components, will continue into 2025 to keep it running as long as possible. The New Lock, being constructed where the Sabin Lock once stood, will match the Pollock's dimensions, 1,200 feet long, 110 feet wide, and 32 feet deep. To date, the project has secured $1.9 billion in funding, but more is needed. Despite full project approval, the next steps hinge on navigating the congressional appropriations process, where funding for the remaining work competes with other national priorities. Kevin McDaniels, deputy engineer for the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Detroit District, highlighted that while estimates are good at specific points, the total cost of the New Lock is likely to be under $3 billion. With continued funding, the project could stay on track and finish within the $2.9 billion range. Once completed, the existing Pollock will continue to operate alongside the New Lock, ensuring that the critical passage of goods through the Great Lakes remains uninterrupted and secure for the future. The New Lock project at the Soo Locks faces several challenges, including rising construction costs, worker shortages, and the constant need for additional funding. Initially estimated at $922 million, the total cost of this project has nearly tripled, now approaching $3.2 billion. This increase is largely due to inflation and higher material costs, which are affecting construction projects across the country. Funding remains a critical priority, with an additional $629 million needed to keep the project on track and avoid further delays. Worker shortages also pose a significant hurdle. A lack of skilled labor has impacted construction efforts, leading to delays and increased costs. This is a common issue across many industries, and for a project of this scale, having the necessary workforce is essential to meet deadlines and maintain progress. Despite these obstacles, the existing locks, including the Poe and MacArthur locks, will continue to operate during construction. This careful planning is crucial to ensure that the shipping traffic remains uninterrupted, minimizing economic impact. The Poe lock, although aging and requiring frequent maintenance, plays a vital role in the U.S. supply chain, particularly for the steel industry. Keeping it operational while the new lock is being built is essential to avoid the kind of economic ripple effects that a prolonged closure could cause. Construction is currently in its second phase, focusing on stabilizing in the approach walls to accommodate modern vessels. This phase is expected to be completed by summer 2024, with significant progress already made, including the placement of numerous concrete caps and ongoing structural work. Once completed, the new lock will significantly enhance the Soo Locks' capacity and efficiency, providing a more reliable passage for the largest vessels that are critical to U.S. commerce. The project aims not just to maintain, but to improve the flow of goods through the Great Lakes, ensuring that industries dependent on this vital waterway can continue to thrive. With both the new and updated Pollock working together, the Soo Locks will be better equipped to handle the demands of modern trade, providing a substantial boost to the economy and reinforcing the strength of a U.S. shipping system. Despite these challenges, the project's completion will mark a transformative improvement in U.S. infrastructure, safeguarding the future of trade through this critical passage. We're committed to releasing two videos a week. Like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more visionary builds.